स्वभाव चिन्मयानन्दं कृपापूर्णं जगत्पतिं हरिषड्वर्गजेतारं नित्यानन्दगुरुं भजे.
Now all you need to do is stop creating this pain shaft or joy shaft. Stop clutching all these painful incidents and creating a shaft. Stop clutching all the joyful things and creating a shaft. The essence of whatever I was talking is stop clutching and creating a shaft. That's enough. You will see suddenly the shaft disappears. Shaft does not exist. Understand? Some of these important truths. Now we are coming to the initiation part. Any thought may suddenly click with you. God, yes, that is what is going on in me. That is what I am doing. One important truth. Even if you want, even if you try consciously, you cannot possess, sit, catch your suffering. Understand? It's a very important truth. Even if you try to catch, you cannot catch your suffering. Because continuously your suffering is also replaced by different thoughts. One person came and asked me an important thing. Swamiji, I am suffering with lustful thoughts. Please give me some solution. I told him, just sit. Half an hour. Your mind should not go anywhere else. Meditate just on lustful thoughts. Think only lustful thoughts. No other thoughts allowed. In 10 minutes he opened his eyes and said, I am not able to concentrate on lustful thoughts, Swamiji. I said, what are you talking? You told me just now you are haunted by those thoughts. I asked you to meditate on it. Just be with it. Now you are saying your mind is not staying on those thoughts. Your mind is going somewhere else. Understand? Fortunately, you can have only one thought at a time. Am I right? You can have only one thought at a time. The moment some other thought is coming in your inner space means the earlier thought has lost its power or influence over you. Am I right? Please come with me. Every statement. Fortunately, you can have only one thought at a time. The moment a new thought has come inside your system, the old thought has lost its power or influence over your system. For example, the moment you decide to stand up and leave, you renounce the thought of sitting and listening. The moment you renounce the thought of standing and leaving, you decided to sit and listen. It's like the moment you stand up, you renounce the thought of sitting. The moment you decide to sit down, you renounce the thought of standing up. Any thought which comes in you newly replaces the old thought. The old thought loses its power or influence over you by new thought. Am I right? One person came and asked me, Swamiji, I am haunted by death fear. I have so much fear about losing my wealth and about my death. Give me some solution. Please remove my fear. I told him, please have a cup of coffee. He said, what do you mean, Swamiji? I said, just think of having a cup of coffee and have a cup of coffee. He said, what is there? How can that help me? I told, the moment you are able to think of having a cup of coffee or decide to have a cup of coffee, the fear, death fear which is haunting your inner space has left your inner space. Am I right? Unless the death fear which is haunting his inner space, leaves his inner space, he cannot think of having a cup of coffee. Am I right? So naturally, a simple thought to have a cup of coffee can remove the so-called powerful death fear. That guy said, no, Swamiji, it looks too simple. But the death fear comes back, what should I do? If it comes back, I have one more cup of coffee, that's all. No, you don't understand how seriously I am talking. You are playing with me. I said, I am not playing. Just simple thing. Understand? Just simple understanding. Fortunately, you can have only one thought at a time. The moment a new thought comes, it means the old thought has lost its power over you. Otherwise, new thought cannot come inside. Otherwise, the old thought cannot be replaced. If the old thought is so strong, it will just multiply and sit on you. It won't leave your inner space. The moment a new thought comes, it means the old thought has lost its power over you. It has left you. Only because of that, a new thought can come inside. So the moment you can have a thought to have a cup of coffee or a cup of water, the so-called death fear has already left you. He is not able to understand. He said, no. It cannot be so simple. I am really having fear, Swamiji. It comes back. I told him, now you know the method how to replace the death fear once, then do the same thing again and again. That's all. He said, no, it comes back. Once I can drink a cup of coffee, next time what to do? Have a cup of buttermilk, that's all. No, it comes back third time. Have a cup of water, that's all. Understand, any thought which comes inside your inner space, newly replaces the old thought, even if it was worst fear, even if it was worst depression, even if it was worst suffering, even if it was worst attachment, even if it was lust, anything it can be, anything it may be, the new thought happening in you proves your inner space is now replaced by a new thought. The old thought has lost its power over your inner space. Any thought which can lose its power over your inner space, why are you afraid of it? Why should you be afraid of it? Constantly we are carrying the fear that we will not be able to conquer our fear. We are carrying the fear we will not be able to go beyond our attachment. We are carrying the fear we will not be able to go beyond our suffering. Understand an important thing. This is what I call click, the initiation. If a thought can be replaced, if a thought can leave your inner space once, it means it can again and again removed as many number of times as it comes. That's all. People tell me, no, how many times I can replace? What is there? Every time when it comes, have a cup of water in front of you, sip once and keep it. Just play with your mind, tease your mind till it stops. Tease your mind till it stops. It may look very funny. No, it looks too simple. How can this be done? I may look like a mad person. Nothing wrong. Looking is perfectly all right than being. Looking is nothing wrong than being. Understand? Simple truth. If a new thought can replace the old thought, then naturally no thought can occupy and possess and torture your inner space eternally. This is what is the click. This is what is the basic truth. just a single, just one thought, a cup of water, the thought to have a cup of water can replace the so-called powerful death fear from you. It can be replaced. It means what? All you need is cup of water to conquer your fear. All you need is cup of coffee to conquer your lust. But mind says, no, 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 it is not that easy. No, no, Swamiji. It comes back, what to do? It again comes back. If it comes back, you also again come back. You also again stand up. Understand, if you can replace 10 times, the 11th time, thought will not come. The frequency will come down. The frequency will come down. Fortunately, you have a pure inner space which does not get corrupted by the flowing thoughts. An important thing, you have fortunately a screen which does not get burnt by the burning scene. If you project a burning scene on the screen through the film, will the screen be burnt? No. Same way, fortunately, you have an inner space, pure inner space, which does not get corrupted, polluted, or get possessed by a particular idea or a thought. Understand? This understanding deeply can completely liberate you from all the sufferings you create for yourself. It can bring tremendous self-healing into you, tremendous freedom to you, and tremendous courage and confidence. See, now, if any fear arises in you, all what you need to do? Cup of coffee. And one more thing, immediately mind will question, no, if I handle all fears like this, what will happen if my property is taken away? Who will maintain my family? Don't bother. You have an innate intelligence, which I call prarapta, powerful enough, capable enough to manage your life using your body and mind. All you need to do is stop creating the sufferings which you are creating. That's all. Please be very clear. Life does not happen because of you. Life happens in spite of you. Life happens in spite of you, not because of you. Come back and clutch again and again. Do not clutch the thoughts and create meaning. Give meaning to it. Unclutch again and again. Come back and rest. You may say, how to unclutch? I don't know. I don't think I can unclutch from my mind. This very thought, I don't think I can unclutch from my mind, you already unclutched, because this new thought can come only if the old thought leaves you. Fear can come only if the lust leaves. Lust can come only if the fear leaves. You can have a thought to have a cup of water only if the fear leaves. You can have a thought to have a cup of coffee only if the suffering leaves. The moment you are able to think that I should have a cup of coffee, already the so-called suffering has left. If that is sitting inside your inner space, how can you have a new thought? You can't. Understand? Handle your enemy one at a time. If you think, no, 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 it's a long story, you don't know, Swamiji. I tried 1000 techniques. I can teach you many more techniques. Nothing works. And my mind is not that simple as you think. Maybe your mind is simple, that is how it worked. Please understand. Even in foolishness, we are not in peak. That's one of the important truths we need to understand. All of us have a very clear idea. We are in the worst ignorance. No. It is not just the simple one truth. If a simple thought of having a cup of coffee can come inside, means any serious thought, it may be pain or suffering or anything, it can be, it has left me. That is why the new thought is able to come. That is why I have inner space to have entertain a new thought. So you, as long as you have freedom to entertain a new thought, you have an inner space to entertain a new thought. Be very clear, you cannot be possessed or tortured by any suffering, any depression and any pain. Because you can just bring one thought, new thought. The moment you bring a new thought, what happened? The old thought has left you. Unless it leaves, you cannot bring a new thought. So be very clear. Your power to bring new thought itself proves you have power to drop the old thought. Instead of looking at the ability to replace, you are looking at the ability to bring it back. You have both. If you are constantly looking at the ability to bring it back, you will create suffering. Oh, it comes back, it comes back, it comes back. If you are constantly looking at the ability to remove, you will feel liberation. Understand? What you mother, that you hatch. The hen mothers the egg and gets the chicken out. Hatches the chicken. Chicken comes out. If you are mothering the thought you can replace any suffering, you will bring that into reality. If you are mothering the thought, no, no, whatever I replace will come back, you will bring that in your experience. If you are mothering the thought that it is going to come back, it will come back. If you are mothering the thought it is going to go out, it will go out. Where you put your awareness, where you put your attention is the important thing. Understand, your very ability to get a new thought shows you have ability to discard a old thought. Any thought can be discarded by any simple thought. This simple understanding is more than enough to unclutch and to rest. One important thing: whenever any fear, any unsolvable problem comes, all you need to do from today is have a cup of water. That's all. And just say, that's all. Your mind will get little perturbed and shaken. Understand, your suffering can rule you just because you are afraid of it. Have you seen in this underworld, Dadas, when they get created, they too will have fear, deep fear. But just your fear towards them will empower them. Same way, your mind too has fear about you. But your fear about your mind, your fear towards your mind just empowers your mind. Your mind also sometimes feels, oh, what is this? But you are more afraid of your mind, then naturally what happens? Your mind gets empowered. All you need to do, understand, this is the initiation. Anything, one more thing, even once, if you can replace your depression from your inner space, have confidence. I replaced. I can do it again. That's all. If 10 times it comes back, let me do it 10 times. That's all. The very clarity, I am going to do. Understand, there is a very beautiful story in Buddha's life. Buddha says, whenever I sat in meditation that I am going to get up, after a few hours, I never became enlightened. Once I decided, if I am not going to become enlightened, I am not going to get up from this seat. Itam asanam sushyate sariram. Very beautiful Sanskrit sloka. Let this body dry up in this very place. Till I became enlightened, I am not going to move. Buddha says, the moment he created this strong clarity, authentic sangalpa, will, he says, next second I became enlightened. Next second he became enlightened. All you need to do, when you replace your suffering, if you are thinking, no, 10 times today I can replace, 11th time if it comes back, tomorrow only I have to try, then nothing will happen. Decide, till it stops coming, I am going to replace. That's what I call courage, dhira. And once you have replaced, means you can start laughing at it. I was afraid of you for so many years. I was getting shaken by you for so many years. I was getting frightened by you for so many years. All it takes to push you out is a glass of water, a cup of coffee, nothing else. A thought to have a cup of coffee, a thought to stand up is more than enough to remove the worst suffering from your inner space. Whatever can be, it looks too simple. That is why the problem is, because it looks too simple, people come and tell me, no, Swamiji, it cannot be so simple. I think you missed somewhere, Swamiji. Really, people think, hey, he's too young, maybe he knows only few things, that's what he's teaching. Now that is the problem. Understand, truth is simple. There is a beautiful traditional song, oh, so difficult to be a devotee of Shiva. Ramana Maharishi sang a very beautiful song. He says, no, so easy the enlightenment signs. So easy. I tell you, it is neither difficult nor easy. Even if I say it is easy, there is little difficult. It is not even easy. It is constantly happening in you. Don't you understand? Every moment a new thought is replacing the old thought. Why are you afraid that you will bring your old thought back? It's like trashing your emails and bringing it back from a trash can. You just bring it back from trash. Just now you trashed it, you deleted, and it has gone. Now you again go into the trash and try to bring that email back. Relax. Constantly your thoughts are getting replaced. This itself shows nothing can possess your inner space. Nothing can overpower you. Nothing can overrule you. You have independence, intelligence to replace any suffering. You have freedom to replace any fear. You have freedom to replace any negativity. Understand, it's a very simple truth. Very simple truth. This is what I call unclutching. If you can understand this one truth and connect with this, if this one truth clicks, this can destroy the root of ignorance, the root of mind. Nothing else is needed. Nothing else is needed. And one more important thing, nothing else can work. Please understand, nothing else can work. Anything you try to do by creating new thought, creating new idea, people come and tell me, Swamiji, I want to escape from my suffering, should I chant some mantra? I tell them that will become one more suffering. Now really, I have seen people chanting Ramakrishna, 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 Ramakrishna. And in between, hey, have you purchased the vegetables? What happened to our market? Did you bring the accounts? Ramakrishna, 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 Ramakrishna. Understand? Many times, when you try to repeat, something, you create a new shaft. People feel offended. How can you say mantra japa does not help? I am not saying it does not help. Of course, let me tell you openly, it does not help. I just thought I'll be socially polite, but let me be open. The satya is much better and much more important than being socially polite. Understand, I tested it in my life for 10 years, not with one mala, I will have two mala. If I finish one mala, one round, I'll push one bead. By that 108, 108. By the time I finish this mala, I would have chanted 10,008 times. I've done enough. I tell you, that only creates one more guilt. You are not able to do mantra continuously. Because by the time you move the next bead, already one thought has come. If somebody records what happens inside your system, Ramakrishna, move the next bead, Ramakrishna, move the next bead, Maharamakrishna, move the next bead. That's what is going on inside. That is what is going on inside. Oh, I think I chanted too many times. Let me count. I know, because I have done it. Not only that, I have always seen people, when they close and with closed eyes, they will start counting the beads. After some time, slowly they will touch with the other hand and see how long it is going to take. Is it going to take 5 more minutes or 3 more minutes, where that bead is there? Let me tell you, it's from my experience. Understand an important truth. Do not try to create one more shaft. Just realize the shaft which you believe exists does not exist. That's all. That's all you need to do. That's all you need to understand. And rest in that unclutched awareness. Nirvigalpa satya. Let me explain exactly what is unclutching. When you sit for meditation, when you sit silently, you will see so many thoughts coming up. Do not connect all of them and give a meaning to it. The moment you give meaning to the words, either you will try to suppress or you will try to execute. Either you will try to go behind them or you will try to suppress them. Understand? Creating a thought is Brahma's work. Maintaining a thought by going behind it is Vishnu's work. Trying to destroying a thought is Rudra's work. If you stop doing all these three work, you will become Parabrahma. That's all. Creation, maintenance, destruction. Relax from all three. Relaxing from all three is what I call unclutching. Let me give you one more detail or a very strong truth. When a thought arises in you, instead of giving meaning to it, just unclutch, means just relax to the source. When a thought arises, if you start giving meaning to it, what you will do, either you will try to do what the thought says, or you will try to suppress, hey, don't come, wait, I am going to meditate. Don't do both. Instead of putting your attention towards the meaning of the sound, just see the source of the sound. That's all. Then your mind will say, no, I am feeling bored. I am feeling bored is a one more thought. Why are you clutching? You see, how will you have the idea that you are feeling bored? The boredom which you experienced 10 years ago, the boredom which you experienced 9 years ago, the boredom which you experienced yesterday are independent experiences. Why are you connecting all of them and giving that idea boredom? Only when you connect all of them and give the idea that this is what is boredom, now you will think, yes, I am having the same experience, I am having boredom. Do not connect and clutch and see. Just see, if your mind says, I am feeling bored, just say, what is boredom? Let me not give some meaning out of my past clutching. Let me see, what do you mean by the word boredom? Let me see how it feels like. Let me see how it feels like. Attend your enemy one thought at a time. If you think all thoughts put together is your enemy, you empowered your enemy. Always understand, when you work with your enemy, divide and rule. If you think all your enemies are gathered together, you will start having all unnecessary fears. Your enemies are not that intelligent as you think always. This is one of the important sutra. Understand? Even in your life. Your enemies are not that intelligent and cooperative, understanding as you think. Just like you, they'll also have a problem among themselves. Your mind, if you think your mind is your enemy, do not empower it by saying it is a one single huge organism. No. Handle it one thought at a time. One thought at a time. Because in your hand you have only one weapon. Means you have only one thought. One thought is one weapon. With one weapon, one thought, how will you handle 10,000 thoughts? No, you can't. So break your mind also. Tell your mind, come one at a time. We will face to face. We will see face to face. Face every single thought. Unclutch from every single thought. Your mind will say, no, 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 half an hour I unclutched. Now again thoughts are coming. The unclutching happened 30 minutes ago, the unclutching happened 20 minutes ago, the unclutching happened 10 minutes ago are totally different individual experiences. Why are you connecting all those unclutching and feeling that this unclutching and that unclutching is same? No. This moment, what is happening in me is an independent experience. A very subtle truth, please understand. You need to put your whole attention, your whole energy, your whole awareness. Only then the click will happen. If the click happens, you are blessed. Because this very single click can be used as a key for so many difficulties and problems in your life. It will revolutionize the way in which your mind functions, the way in which you make decisions, the way in which your fears threaten you, your desires drive you crazy. The whole thing will be reorganized. The whole thing will be revolutionized. If you know any big idea or goal which drives you crazy can be replaced just by a thought of having a cup of coffee, will you have respect for that goal? Will you have respect for that ideal? Suddenly you will see what all you thought as goal does not have any more power over your inner space. You say, no, 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 no. That and all is really needed for life. I don't want to leave this. I don't want to leave that. You may try to catch here, there, here, there. But what to do? Even if you try to catch, it is leaving. It is slipping. How long you will try to catch a river which is flowing? You can't. Suddenly you will see a non-moving, immovable, the authentic self arises in you. That is what I call living enlightenment. Living enlightenment. Understand? An authentic being which does not need your mind to operate your body is what I call living enlightenment. Your being does not need your mind to run your body. If your mind is constantly staying inside you, it is just because of your fear. What will happen to me? How will my body run if my mind leaves me? You do not understand. If your mind leaves you, your life will happen in a much better way. In a much more intelligent way, because your mind is culprit. Your thinking is problem. Your dilemma is suffering. Your movement is depression. When you sit, if thoughts are rising, just remember, let me unclutch. Just unclutch. I am not going to empower this thought by following or by fighting. Let me unclutch. Again, in 2 seconds, one more thought will come. Again, let me unclutch. After a few minutes, you will see continuously you are repeating a thought, unclutching, I am unclutching, I am unclutching. Then unclutch from that too. The moment you remember, you immediately unclutch. Unclutch from the very idea about you. Understand? You have two identity. The identity which you carry and show to the outer world as you are. See, how you wanted world to know you. And the identity which you project to the outer world. That is called ahankara. And another one identity which you carry in you, which you believe as you inside your heart. Which you feel as you inside your heart. This is called mamakara. Your whole life is nothing but the fight between ahankara and mamakara. How you want to project you and how you believe as you. What you want to project you and what you believe as you. Your whole life is nothing but the fight between these two identity. Ahankara, how you project you, will always be much more than what you are. Superiority complex. Mamakara, what you believe as you, will always be much lower than what you are. Inferiority complex. Your whole life is nothing but the suffering between this inferiority and superiority. Tug of war. Whether the thoughts are related to inferiority or superiority, neither give life nor suppress them. Just unclutch. Just unclutch. Now the fear, important fear comes. If I constantly unclutch, who will run my life? Understand? Your prarabdha with which you created your body, that's what I call bio-memory. Your bio-memory is intelligent enough to run your body and maintain your infrastructure and expand your wealth. Trusting this truth is what I call bhakti. When Krishna says, Ananyas chintayanto mamye jana pariyubasade desham nityabhiyuktanam yogakshemam vahamyakam. Whoever resides in me, remembering constantly me, their needs and comforts, I myself bring and see that things stays with that person. Understand? This assurance he gives for the people who have the fear of unclutching and relaxing. I tell you, just try for 10 days. I'm not saying try for whole life. Try for 10 days. Try unclutching for 10 days. If your balance sheet does not increase, forget about me and my technique. Forget about. You will see. It straight away adds to your life. Nothing will be reduced. Nothing will be taken away. Your clarity, your profession, your relationship, your health, everything will be added. 10 days, try this unclutching. Constantly unclutch. Whether you are eating, sleeping, driving. Of course, while you drive, don't close your eyes. Constantly try to unclutch. If it does not improve your life, then forget about it. Don't bother. I tell you, you will never miss it. I have seen how it just transforms your life. Don't have these hypothetical fears. mind exists based on hypothetical fears. If you look into the hypothetical fears, mind will disappear. Mind will disappear. Do not entertain the hypothetical fears of your mind. Just try for 10 days. When I say this, I am responsible for these words. Understand? I know it is getting recorded. I am responsible for what I am talking. Just try 10 days this unclutching. I assure, I have seen, it only adds your health, adds to your wealth, adds to your well-being, and adds to your relationship. Only your fear creates an idea. No, no, no. If I do, who will pay my bills? Who will run my life? You will run your life in a much better way when you are unclutched. You pick up a few thoughts here and there, like a conveyor belt. If the conveyor belt is going on, you pick up whatever you need and create a shaft. Same way, either you pick up all sufferings and create a pain shaft, or you pick up all joyful memories and incidents and create a joy shaft. If you try to elongate joy shaft or break the pain shaft, both is impossible because the shaft does not exist. It is imaginary. Third important thing, fortunately, every new thought proves the old thought has lost its influence over your inner space. This proves no suffering can overtake you. Eternal hell does not exist. Understand? The eternal hell is a foolish concept taught to you to torture, frighten you. Because even here, nothing can be eternal. It just moves. It just moves. There's a beautiful one-liner. You can't step into the same river twice. Because by the time, second time you put your step, river has moved. I tell you, you can't step into the same river even once. Because by the time you put your foot and it reaches the ground, water has moved. Constantly, the very replacement, new thoughts appearing, shows you have an inner space which gets replaced, which gets rejuvenated, which gets refreshed, which is untouchable, which is pure. Because the inner space is pure, you are able to have new thoughts. The new thoughts happening proves the old thoughts have lost its influence over you. So do not be afraid of depression, suffering, fear, desire, anything. Do not be afraid of internal enemies. Let you be liberated from the internal enemies. And the last essence, ultimate thing, do not be afraid of unclutching. A small example, in the north they will have a strange way of, catching the birds. Trap. Strange kind of trap. I have seen in my wandering. I spent my 10 years in walking all over India, begging and eating and sleeping under the trees and meditating. I have seen in north, they will have a trap to catch birds. I think I have a small stick. They even brought a bird to give you a visual. I have seen how they trap the birds. Understand? like this they will put a stick and hang it between the trees. That's all. You will be surprised. How can this trap a bird? Understand? When this is hanging, the bird will come and sit here. Bird will come and sit here. When it sits, just because of its own weight, what will happen? It will become like this. It will become topsy-turvy, upside down. This poor bird, it starts thinking, if it leaves, if it relaxes, it will fall and die. I have seen, for hours the bird will be hanging. The poor guy will be fluttering, will be trying its best, shaking the wings, but he will be hanging, thinking, if he relaxes, if he lets go, he will fall and break his head and die. Have you heard any time a bird falling and breaking his head and dying? No. Fool does not know if he lets go, he can just fly. He can be liberated. Understand? I have seen the bird will be hanging. This hunter fellow will slowly come after 2-3 hours. He will come and just pick up that bird and put it in the cage. How that foolish bird is thinking, if it lets go, he will fall and die. Same way we have the fear, if we let go our mind, if we unclutch, we will fall and our life will become mess. We will disappear. Understand? There is no history, there is no record. The bird which let go, which opened up, has fallen and died. Same way, there is no record. A person who has unclutched has lost something in his life. Just like how that bird, one more thing, that bird feels that stick is a security. It hangs on to it. But poor guy, the hunter comes. Not only he loses the stick which he thinks as security, he is eternally prisoned. Same way, what you think as security, your mind and life, if you hold on to it, what happens? Yama is the hunter, death is the hunter. When he comes, not only what you think as security will be lost, the eternally put to the death, lost the truth. Understand, just like that bird, in a very foolish way, we are hanging on to the stick, the mind, with the fear, if we let go, what will happen, what will happen, what will happen. Sometime I have seen some birds which are flying, they will come and poke this bird and tell, hey, let go. I had the same problem. When I relaxed, I just started flying. I just started flying. All it takes is just 2-3 minutes to balance. See, the bird will be topsy-turvy. When it leaves, maybe 2 seconds it will start falling and it will just turn and start flying. That 2-3 second chaos, courageously facing the 2-3 second chaos is what I call tapas. When you unclutch, there will be some revolution in your life, day-to-day thinking, decision-making, in your daily routine, in your lifestyle. Courageously going through that revolution, going through the transformation which happens in you is what I call tapas. Understand? Rarely the bird which was stuck like this in the trap, but had courage and let go, opened up, it comes back and says, tells the bird which is hanging, hey, let go, relax, listen. I was like you. When I opened up, I never fell and broken my head or died. I only became liberated. I only became free bird. Come on. Understand? If the bird lets go, if the bird relaxes, it will be enjoying its freedom. Same way, if you let go, you will become Paramahamsa. You will become Paramahamsa. Let me tell you, I was hanging. Now, just because I have seen this in my experience, let me tell you, with that courage, with that authenticity, with that truth, with that satya, please understand, when it comes from the experienced inner space, even if your logic is fighting, don't bother, you will have that experience. When it comes from the truth, it will reach your true self and being. All you need to do, just let go, you will become Paramahamsa. You will become Paramahamsa. Let you live enlightenment. Life lived in an unclutched way is what I call living enlightenment.